As a teenager, Yayun Botnik danced in this music video, but within a year, he went from this to this. A young Muslim convert preaching in the streets of Antwerp.
He started to become very religious, always praying. He don't wear Western clothes anymore, he only wear a jalaba. So we really see the signs of radicalization.
Then Yayun said he was leaving to study in Cairo, but when he missed his younger sister's birthday, his father knew his son was actually in Syria.
On that day, no phone call, no message from the brother. That day, I know 100% something is going wrong.
Botnik began to search the internet for any sign of his son.
I discover a video from television station. Inside that video, I see friends from him, from this radical Muslim organization, from this city, from Antwerp. They even speak the language from Antwerp. So when I saw that, no doubt about it, my son is there.
Against the advice of police and his lawyer, Botnik decided to go after Yayun himself. He kept a video diary that he gave to CNN. His search began in the north of Syria with the Free Lawyers of Aleppo.
You show your picture, your son, but yes. He say doesn't seem.
The trail eventually leads to Syria's Islamic extremists.
Alhamdulillah, inshallah.
In his video, Botnik seems to sympathize with them, trying on their weapon, but also capturing extraordinary moments. A jihadi fighter sits down to play a grand piano in an abandoned luxury home. Scenes that change his views on Islam and the Syrian conflict.
The only something I know about Muslim and Islam is that it's like people, a kind of civilization who cannot live in peace.
But you change your mind.
I changed my mind, yeah.
How? Why?
Why? Because I've been in Syria and I've met so many Muslim people, groups, fighting groups like Jabhat al-Nusra with Al-Qaeda, and they are terrorists, and I'm not a Muslim. And if you see what these people done for me, they arise for me sleeping, food, they search for me everywhere.
But Botnik did not succeed at first. It took nearly a year and two trips before he could track down Yayun. He says he found him months later with the Islamist group Jabhat al-Nusra.
They beat me, they almost killed me, they took all my clothes out, they put the cap on me, they hide me because they suspect me, you are CIA. But at the end they believe me and they let me go. And this same leader, he let my son return volunteer.
What was it like when you saw your son?
We were crying. Like, I never cried before when he was missing, when I don't know anything. But the first physical contact, I hold him like a small baby. It's like children who lost the pets, you know, the way.
He was released without charge, now monitored by Belgian police, but barred from speaking to the press. He is also facing charges of recruiting jihadists to fight in Syria, due in court at the end of June. His father insists his son is innocent, but it's easy to see where Yayun gets his taste for adventure and, perhaps, an inflated sense of his own importance.
I have eaten with leaders of Jabhat al-Nusra, with Czechs. They pray for me. They respect me. And why? Because for them it was amazing, amazing that a father from the West, a European, who is not a Muslim, tried to risk his life to come to a war country to look for his own son, a son who is one of them, who become a mujahideen. So I was a hero for them. I was a hero for them.
A hero or an adventurer, a lost child or a jihadi. Many questions unanswered, like father, like son. Atika Schubert, CNN, Antwerp, Belgium.